Hello, I'm Ed Kordick with the Iowa Farm Bureau, and this is a cooperative effort from Iowa State University Extension and the Iowa Farm Bureau to talk about, through some videos, some marketing tools that you can use either in the Iowa Commodity Challenge marketing simulation or also on your actual farm. And this one is about futures, hedging, and basis movement. A little bit of a definition of futures hedging. We're taking an equal and opposite position in the futures market than you have in the cash market. So if you own bushels in the cash market, you would be selling them in the futures market. Whether old crop or new crop, if it's a growing crop even, you can sell bushels in the new crop in the futures for something to be delivered later. And think about it as a farmer that hedges. He takes an action now in the futures market that he's going to have to later on in the cash market anyway. So we're producing these crops to eventually sell them. So we're going to be selling it in the futures market today rather than waiting till later so that we take care of price risk. A little definition of basis is it's the difference between that cash price locally and a futures price in Chicago. And that's basis is very determined by local supply demand, whether there's a big supply at your location or maybe there's a train coming in that the elevator needs to fill in. That's really going to affect supply demand locally and affect your basis. Futures markets in general are affected by worldwide events. So you can think about basis being the localization of that worldwide price. And the calculation for basis is important to do right. If you take cash minus futures, you always end up with the right sign on that basis result. So in this example here, cash at $3.10 less a futures price at $3.55 would get a negative 45 cent basis. Often in the state of Iowa, we have negative basis, and that's often going to be the result. Sometimes late in the old crop year, for example, you can have maybe some positive basis. But always, if you take cash minus futures, you always end up with that exact basis level that you are experiencing your local level. And it is really, you can see it here for those who are picture oriented, the idea of cash markets in the blue, futures markets in the red, and that basis is the difference between those two lines. And that can change, and that's what this video is about. How does a basis change affect a futures hedge? So as you can see, early on in that chart, we had wide basis, and then later on, those two markets came together, didn't they? So they had a lower basis or a smaller basis. So it's important to be able to estimate your basis. And through the Iowa Commodity Challenge, we have workbooks and things can help us to track that local basis. Let's do an example story. It's November, right after harvest, let's say, and we've got a goal of 5,000 bushel of cash corn that we want to sell at $3.70. Now, we estimate basis for late February when we want to come out of that storage and sell those bushels to the market at 30 cents under. And we look at March corn futures, which is out there a little ways into the next year, at $4. So that's the setup for this story on a storage hedge. I might mention, by the way, all these hedges, and we have another video in this series that talks about marketing new crop. And you can use all these tools to market new crop corn and soybeans also. So let's see what happens to this hedging position if the basis is different than what we expected at the beginning. So we're expecting 30 cents under. Let's make that basis move so that it'll affect that net hedge and show the importance of a good estimate of basis. By the way, hedging examples that we use and all the options examples too don't include commission and interest on margin. So there'd be a slight difference in these results. We just like to keep the math simple in these presentations. So here we are. We can track the cash market, the futures market, and basis in this T diagram, and we're going to make the market go lower. First of all, I'd like to say that in our simulation, we use a central Iowa cash market at Bondurant, Iowa. So let's pretend that we've got a goal of $3.70 for central Iowa cash at Bondurant. We sell March corn futures at $4 and we estimate that basis to be 30 cents under. So we're doing something in that futures column right now, selling March corn futures that we're going to have to do later on in the cash market anyway, in late February. We fast forward through time and we sell that cash corn at $3.40. Okay, so the market has gone lower, and the futures market's gone lower too. It's gone lower by 50 cents down to $3.50. So there's a little mismatch here, isn't there? And that's what's important in this short presentation, to show that basis is not always going to equal what you estimated at the beginning. We estimated basis at 30 cents under. The market went lower. Both cash and futures went lower, but the actual basis ended up to be 10 cents under. Why is that? Well, the cash market went 30 cents lower, but the futures market went 50 cents lower. So I sold it at $4, bought it back at $3.50 on the day that I sold the cash commodity, and I gained 50 cents. Sold it high, bought it back low, plus 50 cents. But it more than makes up for my cash loss of 30 cents from my goal. So how could we figure the net in a thing like this? And remember, we were going for $3.70. We would take that $4 initial future sell and subtract out the 10 cents that basis actually ended up being, and that would be $3.90. So we beat our goal by 20 cents. The other way to figure it, of course, is we got $3.40, a check from our elevator, a transfer to our account. We got $3.40 from the elevator Bondurant in Central Iowa in our simulation. And we add in the 50 cents that we gained in futures. And in that way, we get $3.90 also. So we beat our net hedge, and it's all down there in the bottom right-hand corner of that diagram, the 20-cent basis gain that we had versus what we expected, basis being very important when we're using futures and options. Let's take the same story and move the market higher this time and move basis the other way, because basis is not always going to move in our favor as a sold hedge. I sell one March corn at $4. I go ahead and I have a goal of $3.70, so the setup is exactly the same as before. But the market can go higher. You know, markets can go higher or lower. And in this case, the cash market went 50 cents higher. But in this case, also, the futures market went 60 cents higher. It went from $4 to $4.60. So even though we gained 50 cents in the cash market from our goal, we lost 60 cents, and this would create a margin call. And Chad Hard, in another one of our videos, talks about margin flows and how that works. 60 cents loss in futures and a 50 cent gain in cash means that we missed our goal by 10 cents. The actual basis ended up being 40 cents under rather than 30 cents under. That's bad for a sold hedge position. We missed it by 10 cents. It did, you know, do some risk management for us for sure, but that estimated basis was a little bit off and actual basis ended up being a little bit wider. How do we figure the net then? Well, it's the $4 less the actual basis of 40 cents, so it'd be $3.60. Or we can take that $4.20 that we got from the check from the buyer, subtract out that 60 cents that we lost in futures, and we get $3.60. So again, we missed, in this example, we missed our goal of $3.70, and it's all right down there in the bottom right-hand corner of the diagram, a 10 cent miss on basis. So basis is very important when we're using a futures-oriented tool, be it futures hedging directly, options, or even a hedge-to-arrive contract. Basis is going to affect the net outcome. So that hedge-to-arrive contract, cash contract, is going to be very similar. You sign it with your elevator or processor, and you get a lot of the advantages of futures hedging without, you know, talking to a broker. And basis is very, very key to the result. If basis is better or stronger than expected, our price, our net price in that first example, is going to be better. If basis is wider or weaker than expected, more negative in this example, we would say that price is going to be lower than we expected. So these videos, and this video and the others in the series, are in support of the Iowa Commodity Challenge, a marketing simulation that you can participate in with information on the same webpage that you accessed this video.